Hello, this is Dr. Vijay. Welcome to fatty acid oxidation videos. Today I am going to explain about energetics of beta-oxidation. Energetics means how many number of ATPs are produced per complete oxidation of one fatty acid. Please watch all these 6 videos related to fatty acid oxidation before watching this video, so that you will understand better about the process of or steps involved in beta oxidation. I am going to explain energetics of beta oxidation by taking a specific example, that is palmitic acid. As we know, palmitic acid is a saturated fatty acid. Even number long chain fatty acid consists of 16 carbon atoms. Here I have shown an overview of beta oxidation pathway where activation takes place in cytoplasm. Then it will enter into the mitochondrial matrix through carnitine acetyl transport system. And the proper beta oxidation pathway takes place in mitochondrial matrix. Coming to the energy utilization or expenditure of ATP involved in oxidation of fatty acid, especially beta oxidation, the first step where activation, it looks like there is only one ATP utilized, but in reality it requires two ATP. I will explain why. The initial reaction, the activation of fatty acid to acetyl-CoA, or in this case palmitic acid to palmitoyl-CoA, actually two-step reactions. Initially, this ATP undergo hydrolysis to form AMP and pyrophosphate, and this AMP combines with this fatty acid and to form adenylate palmitic acid. And in the second step, this coenzyme A going to break this AMP from this palmitic acid and release palmitoyl-CoA and AMP. And at the same time, this pyrophosphate undergo hydrolysis by pyrophosphatase to give to inorganic phosphate. So the entire reaction requires not one ATP, actually it amounts to two ATP. So keep in mind, we have to subtract these two ATP when we calculate the total ATP produced at the end of this presentation. So this 8-acetyl-CoA enters TCA cycle, where again there will be formation of ATP in the TCA cycle itself, that is called substrate level phosphorylation, and also they will produce reducing equivalents. They will enter components of electron transport chain which are located in inner mitochondrial membrane, and again they will produce ATP. Before going to calculate exact number of ATP, you should know one FADH2 after entering electron transport chain will give 1.5 ATP. One NADH will produce 2.5 ATP. And one acetyl-CoA after entering electron transport chain plus substrate level phosphorylation, it will give 10 ATP. So this point you should remember. And if you see older test book, they have mentioned one FADH2 amounts to 2 ATP, one NADH amounts to 3 ATP. But according to the latest calculation, we have to take this amount, that is one FADH2 is equal to 1.5 ATP after electron transport chain or oxidative phosphorylation, and one NADH will generate 2.5 ATP. And according to this calculation, even one acetyl-CoA will generate 10 ATP. So now we will start calculating energy or ATP production per complete oxidation of palmitic acid. So 8-acetyl-CoA, so that means 8 multiplied by 10, it amounts to 80 ATP. Now we have reducing equivalents generated within the beta oxidation. That is 7 FADH2 and 7 NADH. They will enter electron transport chain. 7 FADH2 multiplied by 1.5. So total there will be 10.5 ATP. Similarly, NADH after entering electron transport chain, 7 multiplied by 2.5, it is 17.5 ATP. So total number of ATPs produced per palmitic acid is 108 ATP. Now here we need to keep in mind, we already utilized or spent 2 ATP for the first step. So we have to subtract this 2 ATP. So the total number of ATP produced per complete oxidation of palmitic acid after going through beta oxidation is 106 ATP. So this is how we calculate ATP production per palmitic acid in case of beta oxidation. So the total ATPs are 106 ATPs per complete oxidation of palmitoyl-CoA or palmitic acid after undergoing beta oxidation. Thanks for watching.